Good afternoon. Bristol's biggest music venue has become Bristol Beacon after its new name was revealed earlier this morning. Previously Colston Hall, the venue's rebrand follows a summer of high-profile anti-racism protests, which culminated in the slave trader Edward Colston's statue being torn down. The venue announced it would change its name more than 3 years ago to tie in with a major refurbishment.
A symbol of hope and community. A focal point for music in the city. A gathering space. Illuminating the way ahead, a place of welcome, warmth and light, an open invitation for everyone to come and share the joy of live music.
That's why this afternoon Longleat has confirmed it will be making a number of staff redundant as it manages the financial impact of the coronavirus pandemic. Despite the success of its recent Night Glow drive-in event, the Wiltshire Safari Park says it's seen a significant fall in visitor numbers following months of lockdown. Now, you've probably seen them, bright coloured plastic barriers on our streets and town centres. They were introduced during the pandemic by councils to help widen footpaths so people could socially distance as they walked past each other. But they have proved unpopular with some traders on this street in Cheltenham.
Parking, offloading, you know, I'm going to say clear street is chock a block. Lorries can't get in to deliver or anything like that. You know, it's just a pain, just a pain.
It's caused massive problems for the delivery drivers. It's caused massive problems out here on the little bit of street that they can park on. So there's chaos out here. And pedestrians are just walking in the middle of the road.
Police are reviewing CCTV to find a missing 21-year-old student from the University of Bath. Alex Unsgaard, who is from Sweden, was last spotted on campus on Friday, but no one has seen or heard from him since. Bristol Hippodrome has announced it will be halting all performances until the end of November. The decision was made as a result of stricter social distancing measures announced by the government yesterday. People in the southwest are being encouraged to get their flu vaccine as new Public Health England research suggests that people infected with both flu and COVID-19 between January and April this year are more at risk of dying. 30 million people in the UK will be offered a free flu vaccine this year. Right, let's get a full look at the region's weather forecast this afternoon with conditions turning distinctly autumnal out there. With the details, here's Amanda Houston.
Great Western Railway sponsors the ITV West Country Weather.
Hello again. Well, after a bit of a groggy start to the day this morning, we are hopeful of a few more brighter spells across parts of the region this afternoon, especially the further west that you are. Still further showers at times in the east. Cooler than of late, though. Highs out to around 15 or 16 degrees. 16 is 61 in Fahrenheit. And as we go through this evening and tonight, it's a real mixed bag of conditions. It's unsettled out there. There will be some clear skies, but also there will be some rainfall coming through from time to time, which could be heavy in places. And those winds really start to strengthen too. And that's going to take us into a blustery start to the day tomorrow with a mixture of sunny spells and hefty showers.
Great Western Railway sponsors the ITV West Country Weather.
Amanda, thank you. That's the way it looks across the West Country for now. There's always more news on our website. And I'm back again with Ellie at 6 o'clock this evening with a full round of the region's news. See you later on. Bye-bye.